Video, I have introduced the unit Fear and Courage. We have done warm-up activity. I have also told you about the characters in the story and also the short summary of the story. Now today, let's read and understand the story, The Hero, written by R.K. Narayan. So let me read out the first paragraph. For Swaminathan, events took an unexpected turn. Father looked over the newspaper he was reading under the hall lamp and said, "Now here, Father and Swaminathan were sitting in the hall. Father looked over the newspaper and he was reading the newspaper under the hall lamp. So this event, whatever happened after reading the newspaper, it brought twist in Swaminathan's life. Whatever happened later was unexpected for Swaminathan. Unexpected, opposite of expected. The opposite is formed by adding prefix un. Then you can see the words over and under. These are prepositions. Okay. So while reading the newspaper, Father asked Swami to listen to the news. Swami, listen to this. News is hats off to the bravery of a village lad who, while returning home by the jungle path, came face to face with a tiger. Now, Father started to read the news in front of Swaminathan. So the news was about the bravery of a village lad. Lad means a boy. So the news was about the bravery of a village boy. This boy was passing through the jungle. And you know, in jungle there are different wild animals, isn't it? And the boy was alone. He was passing alone through the jungle. So while passing through the jungle, he came face to face with a tiger. Now, come face to face means to come close to each other. So the boy came close to the tiger. What will you do if you come close to the tiger? You will be scared, isn't it? So let's see what the boy did. Now, the second paragraph describes the fight the boy had with the tiger and his flight up the tree where he stayed half a day till some people came that way and killed the tiger. Now, here in the second paragraph, it is described about the fight between the tiger and the boy. So when he came face to face to the tiger, what did the boy do? He flight up a tree. Flight means escape. So he escaped from the tiger by climbing up the tree and he stayed there on that tree till half a day, till the other villagers passed by the jungle. Means when half day was passed, some of the villagers, they passed through that jungle and they saw the tiger and they also came to know that the life of the boy was in danger. So they killed the tiger and saved the boy. After reading it through, Father looked at Swami fixedly and said, "What do you say to that?" So after reading this news report, father looked fixedly at Swami. Fixedly means to look continuously for some time. So he wanted to know the opinion of Swami regarding the news report. Now, when father asked Swami's opinion, his opinion was totally different from his father. Swaminathan said, "I think he must have been a very strong and grown-up person and not a boy at all." So Swaminathan replied that this may not be a small boy. He must be a strong and grown-up person, because boys are weak. They are not able to fight a tiger, or they get scared of wild animals like tiger, because tiger is very ferocious animal. And so according to him, he was not a boy, but he was a grown-up and strong person. How could a boy fight a tiger? So he thought that a small boy could not fight a tiger. So he asked his father, "How could a boy fight a tiger? You think you are wiser than newspaper?" Father sneered. So now you are wiser than the newspaper. This is the comparative degree used in the sentence. A man may have the strength of an elephant and yet be a coward, whereas another may have the strength of a straw, but if he has courage, he can do anything. So when Swaminathan gave his opinion regarding the newspaper, father sneered. Sneered means he spoke in a very unkind manner, which showed disapproval. He did not approve with the view of Swaminathan. And he said that a man can be as strong as an elephant. Elephants are very strong. They can lift heavy logs, or they can even lift the trees, isn't it? So according to him, a man can be very strong like an elephant, but he may be coward. And on the other hand, another man may have the strength of a straw. Now you all know what is a straw. Straw is very weak. It can break easily, isn't it? So even if another man has the strength of a straw, if he has courage, he can do anything. It means even if a man is weak, but if he has the courage to do anything, he can do it. Now, already in the previous video, I have told you what is courage. Courage is the ability to do something against odds, isn't it? So now here, the boy faced the odd situation. That means he came face to face tiger, but he had the ability to do something against odds because he was a courageous boy. He had the courage, and so he was able to save himself from the tiger. Courage is everything. Strength and age are not important. So father said to Swaminathan that courage is everything. If we have courage, nothing is impossible. And strength and age doesn't matter. Even if the person is strong or weak, even if he is a grown up or a small child, it doesn't matter if he has courage. Now here you know the word strong. Opposite of strong is weak. Opposite of coward is champion, hero, daredevil. Okay. Opposite of courage is cowardice. or discourage. Discourage, again here the prefix dis is used to form the opposite. Moving further, let's see what was the conversation between Swami and his father. Swami said, "How can it be, father? Suppose I have the courage, what could I do if a tiger should attack me?" Now here, Swaminathan asked a question to his father that, suppose if he had courage and if a tiger comes in front of me, what he could do? Because he was a boy and he did not have the strength, he was not able to fight. So he said, even if I have courage and if a tiger attacks on me, what could I do? So let's see what his father replied. "Leave alone strength. Can you prove you have courage? Let me see if you can sleep tonight in my office room." So now father said to Swaminathan that, let's not talk about strength. Leave the thing apart. He asked him whether he could prove that he had courage. To prove this, he asked him to sleep alone in his office room. A frightful suggestion, Swaminathan thought. Frightful means shocking or unpleasant. Now, whatever suggestion father had given him, it was unpleasant for Swaminathan. What was the suggestion? To sleep alone in his office room. He had always slept beside his granny, and any change in this arrangement kept him trembling and awake all night. Now Swaminathan, he always slept beside his granny, and if there was any change in this position, it would keep him trembling. Trembling means shaking. And he would not be able to sleep whole night because he was very much afraid. He was scared of monsters and all. And so always he used to sleep beside his granny. He hoped at first that the father was only joking. So first he thought that father was just kidding. He is not serious. And so he mumbled weakly, yes, and tried to change the subject. He said very loudly and with a great deal of enthusiasm, "We are going to admit even elders in our cricket club hereafter." Now, when he thought that father was just kidding at that time, in a very slow voice, mumbled means to murmur, to speak in a very slow voice, in a very low voice. So in a very low voice, he said yes to his father. And then he tried to change the topic. He talked about the cricket team. He said that they were going to admit elders in their cricket team. Now the cricket team was for just children, but now they had decided to admit elders as well in their cricket team. So he told about it to his father to change the topic. "We are buying brand new bats and balls. Our captain has asked me to tell you." So he said that their team was going to buy brand new bats and balls for the team. And he said that his captain has asked him to tell you this. His captain has suggested to tell about it to Swaminathan's father. "We will see about that later," father cut in. So father interrupted in middle when he was talking about the cricket team, and he said that they would talk about it later, afterwards. Later means afterwards. You must sleep alone hereafter. He said to Swami that you must sleep alone hereafter. Henceforth, you have to sleep alone. Because the father understood that Swami did not want to sleep alone, and so he is changing the topic. But again, he came on the same topic and he again reminded him to sleep alone thereafter. Swami realized that the matter had gone beyond his control. From a challenge, it had become a command. He knew his father's tenacity at such moments. Now Swaminathan understood that now this matter has become very serious. First, it was just a challenge. Father had given him a challenge, and he had accepted that. But now, from a challenge, it had become a command. Now, father was giving him a command. He was forcing him to sleep alone in his office room. And he understood his father's tenacity. Tenacity means the quality of being very strong-minded. Now, father has made up his mind that Swaminathan had to sleep alone in the office room. So, opposite of admit is refuse or reject. Opposite of elder is younger or junior. By, sell. Later, antecedent. These are the opposite words in this para. Moving ahead, from the first of next month, I'll sleep alone, father. Now, when father asked him again to sleep alone, at that time, Swaminathan replied that from the first of the next month, he would sleep alone in the office room. No, you must do it now. It is disgraceful sleeping beside granny or mother like a baby. Now here, Swaminathan's father denied. He said, no. You must sleep alone now onwards and not from the next month. You have to do it right now. He further said that it was disgraceful. Disgraceful means it was not good to sleep beside granny or mother like a baby. You know, when we are babies, we sleep beside our mother or grandmother. But as we grow up, we sleep alone, isn't it? So father also wanted that Swaminathan should sleep alone because he was no more a baby. You are in the second form and I don't like the way you are being brought up, he said, and looked at his wife who was rocking the cradle. Now Swaminathan's father said that now you are in the second form. Here, second form is the word used in British English, which means the second year of secondary level. Now primary means first to fifth. Secondary means sixth onwards. So second year of secondary, it means seventh standard. So he said, now you are grown up, you are not a baby, and it is not good to sleep beside mother or granny. And his father did not like the way he was being brought up. Means he was pampered a lot, he was not allowed to sleep alone. So these things father did not like at all. And while saying this, he looked at his wife. Whose wife? Swaminathan's father's wife, means Swaminathan's mother. Swaminathan's father looked at Swaminathan's mother who was rocking the cradle. Now, rocking the cradle here refers to the person since nasir when our mother has more emphasis or more influence on bringing up of the children. So the way in which Swaminathan was brought up, father did not like, and he thought that Swaminathan's mother was responsible for that. Let's move ahead. Swami's father sat gloomily gazing at the newspaper on his lap. Now, after saying this, Swaminathan's father sat gloomily gazing at the newspaper on his lap. There was a newspaper on his lap and he was gloomily gazing at it. Gloomily means in a very unhappy way. Father was not happy. Gazing means to look steadily at something for a long time. Swami rose silently and tiptoed to his bed in the passage. Granny was sitting up in her bed and remarked, "Boy, are you already feeling sleepy?" Now, when he saw that his father was unhappy, he rose silently. Rose is the past tense of rise. Since he got up from his place silently and tiptoed to the bed in the passage. Tiptoed means to walk on the toes, keeping the heels off the ground. So silently he moved to his bed, which was in the passage. So when he went to the bed, his granny or his grandmother asked him whether he was really feeling sleepy. "Don't you want to hear a story?" So, as I have already told you, whenever Swaminathan used to sleep with his grandmother, she used to tell him stories. But that day, he just went to bed and he was pretending to sleep. So, grandmother asked him whether he did not want to listen to any story. Swami made wild gesticulations to silence his granny, but that good lady saw nothing. So now Swami made gesticulations. Gesticulations means some movements with his hands or arms. Means he wanted to tell his granny to keep quiet. And he wanted to pretend as if he was sleeping so that father will not ask him to sleep in the office room alone. But grandmother did not pay attention to his gesticulations. So Swami threw himself on his bed and pulled the blanket over his face. So what Swami did? He pulled himself on the bed and he took a blanket over his face and he pretended to be sleeping. Granny said, "Don't cover your face. Are you really very sleepy?" Now, when he took blanket over his face, at that time, Granny said not to cover the face. And she again asked whether he was really, really feeling very sleepy. Swami leaned over and whispered, "Please, please, shut up, Granny. Don't talk to me and don't let anyone call me even if the house is on fire." Now here, Swaminathan told his granny to shut her mouth. And he said, "Do not talk with me. And even if somebody comes to call me, even if the house is on fire, if the house is set on fire, even in that worst situation, don't wake me up." He said that if I don't sleep at once, perhaps I shall die. So he further told his granny that if he would not sleep at that moment, he would die. Why he would die? Because of fear of sleeping alone in the office room. He turned over and curled and snored under the blanket till he found his blanket pulled away. So what he did? In his blanket, he turned over and curled and snored. Curled means to make a curved shape of his body. And he started to snore. Snore, the sound which the people make while sleeping, that is snoring. So he was snoring as if he wanted to show that he was sleeping. So he did that till somebody pulled his blanket. Presently, his father came and stood over him. "Swami, get up," he said. So who pulled his blanket? His father, Swaminathan's father, pulled Swaminathan's blanket and told him to get up from his bed. Granny pleaded, "Why do you disturb him?" So Granny pleaded. Pleaded means requested. She appealed to Swaminathan's father not to disturb him as he was sleeping. "Get up, Swami," said the father for the third time, and Swami got up. So father asked him to get up thrice. So at the third time, finally, Swami got up from his bed. Father rolled up his bed, took it under his arm and said, "Come with me." So what Swaminathan's father did, he rolled up Swami's bed, took it under his arm and asked Swami to go, come along with him. Swami looked at Granny, hesitated for a moment and followed his father into the office room. So when the father rolled up the bed and asked him to come with him, at that time, Swami looked at his granny. He wanted that his granny should stop his father from taking him to the office room. He hesitated. Hesitated means to wait for some time because he was worried. He was scared to sleep alone. He did not want to go. And so he stopped. He waited for some time. He wanted to see if granny is asking his father not to take him in the office room. On the way, he threw the look of appeal at his mother and she said, "Why do you take him off to office room? He can sleep in the hall, I think." So when he came out from the passage along with his father, he saw towards his mother. He gave a look of appeal. Appeal means a request. He made a very sad face and he wanted to ask his mother to stop father from doing so. So mother, as I told you earlier, she loved him a lot. She pampered him a lot. So she said to Swami's father that, "Why are you taking him to office room? He can sleep here in the hall." "I don't think so," father said, and Swaminathan slunk behind him with bowed head. So father said that, "I don't think that he will sleep in the hall." And Swaminathan slunk behind him with a bowed head. Slunk means moved secretively in fear and shame. He was very much embarrassed. He did not want that somebody should notice him, that he was afraid. And so in that shame and fear, he bowed his head and moved along with his father. "Let me sleep in the hall, father," Swami pleaded. So Swami requested his father to allow him to sleep in the hall. "Your office room is very dusty and there may be scorpions behind your law books." Swami further said that the office room was very dusty. There was dirt all along the office room. And he also said that there may be scorpions in the in his law books. In his office room, there were a lot of law books. and it was dusty, means they did not visit often that room, and so it was dusty. So Swaminathan said his father that there may be scorpions, they may bite me, and so please allow me to sleep in the hall. There are no scorpions, little fellow, sleep on the bench if you like. So father replied that there were no scorpions in the room. He also suggested him that he could sleep on the bench if he liked. Can I have a lamp burning in the room? So when father did not agree to Swaminathan sleeping in the hall, so finally Swaminathan asked father if he could keep the lamp burning so that at least there may be light in the room and he would not be afraid of darkness. No, you must learn not to be afraid of darkness. So father replied, no, you cannot keep the lamp burning because you should not be afraid of darkness. You have to prove that you are courageous, and courageous people are not at all afraid of darkness. And so he did not allow him to keep the lamp burning. It is only a question of habit. You must cultivate good habits. So father said that it was a matter of habit. You should develop a habit of sleeping in the darkness. He asked him to cultivate good habits, to inculcate good habits in him so that he can become a good human being in future. Will you at least leave the door open? So now, when he denied to keep the light burning, at that time, he asked him whether father would allow him to keep the door of the office room open. All right, but promise you won't up your bed and go to your granny's side at night. So father agreed and he said that, okay, you can keep the door open, but you should not come out of the room, and at night you should not go and sleep beside granny. If you do it, I'll make you the laughing stock of your school. So he said that in the night, if you come out of the room and sleep beside your granny, then I will make you the laughing stock of the school. Now, laughing stock means a person who is regarded as a foolish. Means other people think that he is foolish and make fun of him. So he said that if he will not listen to him, if he will come out of his room and sleep beside granny, then he will let his friends know about it. And then his friends would laugh at him and he would be the laughing stock. Swami felt cut off from humanity. He was pained and angry. He did not like the strain of cruelty he saw in his father's nature. He hated the newspaper for printing the tiger's story. He wished that the tiger had not spared the boy who did not appear to be a boy, after all, but a monster. Now, see the condition of Swami, how he felt. He felt that he was cut off from humanity. Cut off from humanity means he thought that he was completely separated from his family. He had to stay alone in the office room. He had to sleep alone. So he felt that he was completely separated from other members of the family. He was pained and angry. He had lot of pain in his heart. He was badly hurt and he was also very angry at his father. He did not like the strain of cruelty he saw in his father's nature. Now, strain of cruelty means a tendency of being mean and unkind. He thought that his father was very mean. He was very unkind to him. And so he did not like this nature of his father. He hated the newspaper for printing the tiger's story. Now, why he hated the newspaper? Because of this story, there was an unexpected turn in his life. And so he hated the story which was printed in the newspaper. He wished the tiger had not spared the boy, who did not appear to be boy, but after all, a monster. So according to him, boy would not be a small child, he must be a grown up or strong person. But now, as the news was printed that he was a boy, so he thought that why the tiger spared the boy, why he did not kill the boy? Because the boy was safe, because he was spared by the tiger. Now Swaminathan had to prove himself courageous, isn't it? So he thought that why the tiger did not kill him? Because now for him, the boy did not appear to be a boy after all. He appeared to be a monster. He thought that the boy was monster of his life. Because of that boy, he had to sleep alone now.